Hello, good people. So currently, there are no VR headsets in the same price range with a wider field of view than the Pimax over here and the FOV index over here. On paper, the specs of these two headsets we are comparing today are pretty similar, and if you're looking to buy one of these high-end VR headsets, then you might want to know what the differences are and which one you should buy. Many of you have asked for a comparison of these two, so here we are. First, if you want to see more videos from and to VR enthusiasts, consider subscribing if you haven't yet. And now, let's jump in. I've got the Pimax 5K Plus here and the FOV Index. I decided to not compare the Pimax 5K XR version that has the OLED displays because I thought it'd be fairer to compare the LCDs with each other. Throughout this comparison, I'm using the ROV test app, which I'll link below in case you want to check. Let's start with the display clarity. The resolution of the Pimax 5K Plus is 2560x1440 per eye, while the FOV Index has a resolution of 1440x1600 per eye. Both use dual LCD panels, but they are custom per headset. On the Pimax, if I focus on a spot directly in front of me, I can tell that the Pimax resolution is better than that of the FOV Index. Objects and text are sharper and a bit more refined. However, in the Pimax, if you look at the sides or move your head, you can see distortion. I also noticed that objects at a distance could shimmer in the Pimax, which can be a little distracting. So while the Pimax wins in resolution, the FOV Index does provide a more uniform image. The clarity of the FOV Index is great and clear overall. It makes the FOV Index have a more comfortable display to look at. Since both headsets use LCDs, the blacks are noticeably grayer than a headset with an OLED display. I can't notice much of a difference between the blacks of these two headsets though. The screen door effect is still there on both headsets, but so much less noticeable than the original HTC Vive or the original Rift. I think both headsets have very similar SDE. I mean, it's hard to tell the difference here. As for glare, it's noticeable on both at high contrast scenery like white text on a black background. I've said it on our FOV Index review already, the glare seems more noticeable than the original Vive. It looks the same on the Pimax, except on the Pimax the glare looks farther away from the center, probably because the lenses are bigger. It's worth noting that glare is not a big deal in most scenery for me. I forget about it most of the time, but some people can be more sensitive to this. As for the sweet spot, I feel that the Pimax has a bigger one. The FOV Index becomes blurry faster at a slight movement. Now, on the Pimax, you can set a refresh rate of 90, 72, and 64 Hz. The FOV Index can do 90, 120, and 144 Hz. Playing a game at the higher refresh rates of the FOV Index makes everything look noticeably smoother and also shows me more detail. This should also prevent motion sickness if you are prone to that. So, in this area, the FOV Index beats the Pimax. And any other headset at the moment? Both headsets have a mechanical IPD adjustment. This allows you to adjust the lenses to match your eyes and thus to make the screen sharper. The Pimax 5K Plus has a range of 60 to 73 mm, while the FOV Index has a range of 58 to 70 mm. If you are far below or above this range, it might be the best option to get the headset closest to your range for the best sharpness. The field of view, probably the most interesting part of this comparison. So the Pimax 5K Plus is big for a reason. It fits two wide displays in there to accomplish the wide FOV of about 200 degrees. I have to note, it's not actually 200 degrees, which I'll show you in a bit. In comparison, the Rift S and HTC Vive headsets have an FOV of about 110 degrees. You can set the Pimax FOV in three different settings, large, normal, and small, so you can decide which one you prefer. The FOV Index accomplishes the wider FOV with certain design choices, like allowing you to put the displays and lenses closer to your eyes with this dialer. If you put it at the closest distance, FOV says the increase is about 20 degrees more over the HTC Vive. The FOV Index FOV looks about the same as the smallest FOV setting of the Pimax 5K Plus. When measured in the ROV test app, the smallest FOV setting of the 5K Plus is about 120 degrees horizontal and vertical, while the FOV Index is 106 degrees horizontal and 130 degrees vertical. The largest FOV of the Pimax is much larger, about 160 degrees horizontal and 120 degrees vertical, so yes, the Pimax 5K Plus beats the VOV index here by far. While you're watching this video, don't forget to leave a like if this video was helpful to you. What about performance? We have tested both headsets on our Venom PC, specs are down below in our description, and both headsets perform well on this system, although you need to spend a lot more time with the Pimax settings to get it to look right at the best frame rate. The Pimax software called Pi2 is buggy, and I found myself having to restart the device a lot to use it properly. In certain resource-intensive games like No Man's Sky, it was hard to get a decent frame rate on the Pimax, while the index is doing a decent job after some tweaking. In other games, the Valve Index is almost immediately ready to use out of the box. Both use the same tracking system. They use the Vive base stations, and I've tested both headsets on the first generation base stations. And I've said it before, this system has always been the most accurate tracking system for me. It's worth noting that this means you can use any HTC Vive accessories or controllers with both headsets. As for audio, the Valve Index uses off-ear speakers that don't touch your ear, yet it still manages to direct crispy clear sounds into your ears. It feels like the sound is coming from around you rather from inside your head. Yes, and it has been the best audio solution we've seen in a VR headset so far. Unfortunately, the Pimax only comes with a 3.5mm audio jack. Both have an integrated microphone, and I feel both mics sound good, but I am leaning towards the Valve Index here too. When it comes to comfort, we are comparing the Pimax 5K Plus using the original straps. The Valve Index comes with a strap system, much like the HTC Vive Deluxe Audio strap. Here, the Valve Index weighs twice as much than the Pimax. The Pimax weighs about 470 grams, while the Valve Index weighs about 800 grams. However, the Valve Index straps balance out the front heaviness, while the Pimax original straps are not doing that. So most people who own the Pimax print out adapters to put the Deluxe Audio strap on it. So regarding comfort, the Valve Index strap is going to be the most comfortable out of the box for most. But if you put the Deluxe Audio strap on the Pimax, then they are pretty similar, but the Deluxe Audio strap is also $100. I have to note that the original Pimax straps are more comfortable for seated games though, at least if you use a chair with a high headrest. So the Pimax is lighter. This is probably because the Pimax compensated weight with lighter material. So the Pimax does feel like it could break more easily. The build quality of the Valve Index feels better. As for the ports, both use similar ports, a USB 3.0 and a DisplayPort cable. Both also have an external power adapter to power the headset. Last but not least, if you are a glasses wearer, then the Pimax would be more comfortable. It's much easier to fit glasses in the Pimax headset than on the Valve Index. Any frames bigger than this one won't fit at all in the Valve Index, unfortunately. And even if you are able to fit your glasses in the Index, you won't be able to enjoy the larger FOV since you'll be farther away from the lenses. If you do want to use the Valve Index with prescription glasses, then I recommend getting prescription adapters for it. Witmo VR has some that Chary has been very happy with, I'll link it below. They will cost $65 extra though. Before we conclude this video, let's talk about pricing. The Pimax 5K Plus sells for $699 and the Valve Index headset sells for $499. Both prices are for the headset only, so without the base stations or the controllers. If you don't have the base stations or controllers, then you will need those as well, which will add to the total price. To summarize, the Pimax 5K Plus has better resolution, but the Index has the best uniform image. The SDE, glare and IPD adjustment is not that different, but the Index wins on refresh rate, audio, comfort and build quality. The 5K Plus wins on FOV by far and is better suited for glasses wearers. So, is the $200 extra for the Pimax worth it over the Index? For the normal VR consumer, I do not think so. While the Pimax offers an incredible wide experience, the Valve Index does better in a lot of areas for a lower price. I think a reason the Pimax could be worth it over the Index is if you are a VR flight and racing simulator enthusiast, where wide FOV and higher resolution is important. So, what do you think? Do you agree or disagree with our points? Let us know below so everyone can read it. Maybe your comment will be able to help them out as well. A special thanks goes to artArmin, our right-hand patron. A special shout-out goes to his Patreon page. Everyone, thank you for your support and watching, and I want to see you in the next VR video. And as always, VR on! If you're looking to buy one of these high-end VR headsets, and the FOV index is over here.